Fill patterns are used to graphically represent something in a view. Typically, fill patterns are used as surface patterns or cut patterns in the graphic asset of a material. A project template includes a predefined list of fill patterns for use in the project. If the list does not contain the pattern you would like to use, you can define a new fill pattern in the project. In this example, we open the Fill Pattern dialog through the Material browser. You can also open it from the Manage tab on the Additional Settings dropdown. Fill patterns are defined as either drafting patterns or model patterns. A drafting pattern maintains size and spacing of elements of the pattern, regardless of view scale. For example, a pattern defined with horizontal lines spaced 1.5 millimeters apart will always produce parallel lines 1.5 millimeters apart. On the other hand, a model pattern is scaled when you change the scale of the view. The definition of the model pattern includes the real-world spacing for the elements of the pattern. When you are working with fill patterns for materials, you will typically use drafting patterns for the cut and model patterns for the surface. To create a new fill pattern, in the Fill Pattern dialog, begin by selecting the type of pattern to create. In this case, we select a drafting pattern because it will be used as a cut pattern for a material. Next, click New. When you create a simple pattern, you define the angle and spacing of the lines. Click the crosshatch radio button if you want to create a second set of parallel lines that run perpendicular to the first set of lines. Then give the pattern a name and click OK. To create a fill pattern that is more than sets of parallel lines, select the Custom radio button. In the Custom section of the dialog, click Import. Fill patterns are imported from PAT files. PAT files are special text files that contain the instructions to create the fill pattern. Select the PAT file that contains the custom pattern you want to use. Revit installs a default revit.pat file that contains a number of custom patterns. You can also import custom PAT files. If you want to import a PAT file as a model pattern, make sure the file includes type definitions for each pattern in the file. Select the pattern to use. Change the name and import scale if desired. Once the fill patterns are created in the project, they can be used in the definition of materials and filled regions.